Hello, my Mentoraholic family, and welcome back. This week, I want to do a little project. See, I'm not really good with kits, but when I was at the Spring Miniature Show in Chicago, this lady talked me into getting this kit, just three of them. She said it was really simple. So remember Black Thorne? You can follow her on Etsy. But these ladies were so cute. So I'm going to try to mimic what she told me to do and see if we can get them to come out looking right. So let me see if I can get you a close-up. Okay, so this is what they're supposed to look like when they're completed. So you have A. And that's what it's supposed to look like. You have B. And C. Now, she said it was easy to handle, so I have to cut these out. Let me see. If I can go ahead and open this up and get you a close-up. So, look how that, see? So, I have to cut all these little, like, almost look like wires. I don't know how I'm going to get her free from that X-Acto knife, maybe. See, this is why me and kids don't get along. So, we got to get her off these wires, then paint her, and then go over her with some, I guess, metallic. Oh my goodness. Okay. No longer are we going to play and procrastinate. Let's just go ahead and get started. Going to take one out of the package. And I'm nervous. I got my X-Acto knife. So she's saying to just detach her from these little, I don't know what they call these things, but oh my God, please don't let me mess up. There. Just lightly touching it with the X-Acto at the tip. Let's see. This is difficult. So I'm going to take the arm and just removing just the little holders from the actual yoga person. Ooh, I don't want to cut nothing. It's easy, but is scary. So she's saying to detach. So I'm gonna detach. So I'm gonna pull these. My God, these things pop everywhere. Oh, they're popping everywhere. Jeez, hope I can find them. Okay, so I have this much left, which she's sitting on, so I'm just gonna, ooh, scary, okay. Here we go, okay. Got the knife, and I'm just, need some safety goggles for these things. I think I got her free, so just go over the bottom. Well, she's smooth pretty much everywhere except for the bottom, so might have to get some sandpaper. Now, this stuff is dangerous. Popping everywhere. I have to vacuum. I swear I think one of these little son of a guns popped down my throat. But I'm going to paint this little lady. So I'm going to use this dark blue gray. Probably going to add a little bit of black to it and see what we come up with. Let's try it. So I have all three of them separated from the little dangerous pointy.
I mean, these things are dangerous. I don't care what anybody says. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Because I know she said she used, what's that? Some type of charcoal black. So I had this dark blue gray. Let's see what that's going to look like. Kind of looks gray. I might have to add a little bit of black to that. So I'm going to add a little bit of black. I'm going to add it to it and see if we can kind of get a charcoal black color. Because I know when I looked up how to get the charcoal black, it had mentioned the gray, which is made up of black and white, but they added a little blue. So I went and got the blue gray, the dark blue gray, added a little black, and it looks kind of like a charcoal. But we're going to find out. Okay, let's see what happens. I don't want to, I don't know. All right, let's put her right here. And we can, you know, paint her easier. Yeah, not bad. It's almost like the feet don't want to stay in there. You know, I'm just going to use my fingers because the tweezers are not holding. So, let my fingers hold. Looks like this is going to take two coats. Okay. Did pretty good. Okay, so I'm going to have to let the top of her dry and then do the feet. In the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and do the other two. All right, we're on the second one. I think these are going to look so good in whatever house I put them in. You know, thinking Thornhill, though. I love these little statues. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna have to do two coats. Okay. Third one. Now, I know the bottom really does not need to be painted, but in my mind, it's the details. So if someone was to pick her up, I don't want a black body in a white bottom. It's not gonna look right. It's like somebody's being lazy. So I have all three of them painted, and I kind of feel like it's going to need a second coat. So yeah, I'm going to do that, and then when it's completely dry, then, you know, I'll bring you back, and we'll do the little decorations that's on the package, and hope it works. All right, time to dry. All right, let's go ahead and get started painting these figures, these little yoga figures that I got from the miniatureshow.com in Chicago this year, 2024. I thought they were so cute, and I decided I'm going to put them in my Thornhill Arts and Craft Room. It's going to be so adorable. So I got my paintbrushes ready. I have, like, literally, I have four of these babies. Although I'm going to use three, probably only three. So I cannot tell you what size these are. I know that they're real fine. I don't have the measurement on here. It says 3/0. I hope you can see that. 3/0 is what these paintbrushes are. So I'm going to use my paint tray going to use my water cup. I'm going to, not sure which color paint I'm going to use, but they're all metallic. So I have green, blue, purple, gold, and let's move these over so we can see this copper. Now, I'm not sure which one I'm going to use, but I might use one on each figure, or I might mix them. All I know is it's going to be a lot of detail work. So while I'm working, I want to listen to my tunes. Yeah, me and my music, you know, me and my music, dedicating it to my miniatures. So any songs that I play and you hear on this channel, we're talking about miniatures here, okay? And you know, I also have another blue. This is a more like a darker blue. There, you can see that better. I'm not sure which one we use, but we're going to figure it out. So let's go ahead and get ready to start playing the music. This is going to take some time, and I know these look like, those are tiny. That's not going to take long, but what did I say? The details in the miniatures is what makes the miniatures. All right, let's get started.